Greetings, Earthlings. Welcome back to Delta Force. Today's mission is Safe Passage, and from the looks of it, it is going to be a pretty difficult mission because we have to escort an Indonesian president this time around, and escort missions usually are pretty difficult, so I'll try sticking to the mission parameters initially. However, once if that proves to be too difficult, I might consider being a little more proactive in actually going around and hunting down enemy troops before they become a problem. So yeah, without further ado, let's see what this mission is about. Mission. That is a seems like a short escort, but I'm pretty sure that is a long escort route. But anyway, escort the Indonesian president during his tour through special operations area, SOA. Execution. You will rendezvous with the convoy northwest of the city of Teluk Batang. I think that is how you call it. I want to say the names are weird, but then again, I mean, if you don't know the language, all names are weird. So, escort the convoy through your checkpoints to the city of Putianak. Should the convoy come under attack, you are authorized to neutralize all attackers. Your mission will be successfully completed when the security of the president's limo has been assured. So I'm guessing there's no element of stealth to this, so we are free to utilize the M4, since it is the far superior gun anyway. Or maybe even the LMG. Let's see. Both SIGINT and HUMINT collected by J2 suggest the terrorists may be preparing an attack against the Indonesian president during his tour. Exact numbers of enemy forces that would take part in this attack are unknown at this time. J2 believes that if an assassination attempt is launched, it would take place at the hilly area at the halfway mark between the two cities. So that is where action takes place. Allied support. Neither Alpha nor Charlie teams have been assigned to this mission. What? Why? However, an MH-60 Black Hawk from Black Widow squadron will be providing close air support should the terrorists launch an assault on the convoy. That is nice, at least we have some air support. I don't know what these folks are. That is probably the Black Hawk, and these are probably the people that we need to escort, I suppose. But at any rate, it seems like a confusing mission. I hope at least we have some allies, you know, at least some people who are, you know, along with us for the ride, not just, you know, me and the president all by a lonesome. Air support should the terrorists launch an assault on the convoy. A detachment from the Indonesian army will also be guarding the president's convoy. At least we have the Indonesian army to fall back on. I'm pretty sure they would be just as skilled as our Delta Force operatives, because let's face it, our Delta Force operatives are weaker than the militants that we've been facing thus far. I don't know why, but for some reason this map looks like the map of the moon to me, with all the craters and stuff. Situation. Due to the success of recent operations against them, the terrorists have issued threats against the safety of the Indonesian president. In order to show that he cannot be intimidated by the INT, the president has decided to tour through one of the special operations area. This tour is a politically important trip, and interference from the IMT cannot be allowed. Well, that explains why, you know, the fact that this president is touring through the special operations area is why, it sort of explains why we, the Delta Force, are protecting him, because otherwise it would be, you know, up to the Indonesians. Now, this is something that I do not like, so I will be changing it up to, you know, the Spec Ops 45. But apart from that, everything else seems just fine and dandy, so yeah, let's go ahead and start this mission. Attempt number 11. And yeah, things didn't go as planned, and well, we are currently proceeding as we can. You know what, let me just be a little more proactive and go ahead and try assaulting the enemies at their bases first. I suppose the people on the right would have been closer, but hey, even these were. Let me just go ahead and switch to the grenade launcher because, well, it's far easier to utilize. I hope they don't get all aggro and kill me instead. Because that is what I intend to be doing. Now, these guys have started mobilizing themselves. Are you guys dead? That luckily was a dud. Ow! Now, there are more people behind me. Let me just go get down this hill and start, you know, progressing towards them, because otherwise it's gonna get more and more difficult. As you can see, there are lots of enemies. Lots of enemies in this area. And the thing about these enemies is that they can kill you, actually. If you're not careful, they can totally kill you. So you better be careful when you're doing this stuff. Pulling stunts like this, leaving your objective to go and kill yourself some bad guys. But I call it some proactive protection. Now, there are lots of enemies. It's sort of almost like an infinite enemy spawn. But as you can tell on the map, that these guys are actually not infinite. They are pretty finite. It's just a matter of whether you can deal with them or not. Thus far, our enemies seem to be dying, dwindling, and we seem to be holding up rather well. Oh, come on. Oh, come on. Let me go ahead and provide assistance to my fellow men, who all seem to have all been wiped out. So I guess it's only, you know, whether the president is alive or not does not actually matter. What really matters is whether or not Bravo is alive. Bravo 1, I mean, Bravo 1 is alive. As long as Bravo team is in the game, there's always hope, even if the president might not be there anymore. Is basically the entire, you know, the entirety of what these guys are trying to say. Oh, where are these guys? Are you guys dead? Are you guys dead yet? I see you back there. What the fuck is the helicopter doing over there? I see some enemies over here, over yonder. And the president does not seem to be in any sort of threat. Some enemies over here. Yep. And where else are they? In front of me? Good. Let them have a face full of grenades. Wait, the helicopter actually kills enemies? Whoa, but that's a new one. Now, I'm sorry for all the Indonesian folk dying, but I suppose this does set a good example of what exactly Delta is capable of. You know, their strengths. That they succeeded, they managed to succeed where the Indonesian presidential guard failed. Even though, you know, they were pretty competent in their own right. Now who's... There's no friendly here. It's just a helicopter. There's no friendly apart from that. Who else is there? Is literally everybody else dead on the map? Who? Let me just go ahead. Let's proceed with mission then.
Blackwood of the King 6. Limo is secure. Good work, Bravo.
That is all that mattered in the end, didn't it? The limo being secure and, well... Sad to say, you guys are just soldiers. You guys won't matter. Good work, Black Hawk unit. Black Hawk, rather. I don't know how to respond to these helicopters. But yeah, this car right here. This car, which is in fact these two cars. They're the same cars. Now, I've been trying to explain this quite some time, but I don't like repeating myself when I'm having to do that. So these two cars are essentially radio jammers. What these cars do is they block all radio communication signals in the area, so that, one, it becomes difficult to coordinate an attack, and two, it becomes impossible to trigger an IED that works off, mobile signals. Like you have to call to, set off the IED or give it a remote. IED is basically remote detonation switches. Another car like this is called an igniter, and these radio jammer cars, they usually typically escort the vehicle so that, the vehicle is safe, the main vehicle that requires escorting. There's another car called the jammer, and what that car does is it essentially goes. Is there a chicken in there? What? Strange. But yeah, essentially, there's a chicken in here as well. That does not seem to be like a symbol or anything. Oh yeah, it is a symbol. I thought it was like there was an actual live chicken in there. Yeah, but so basically what igniter cars do is they patrol the same route like 24 to 6 hours before the actual escort takes place, and they blast a lot of encoded messages over, the radio over a vast variety of radio frequencies. The aim is simple. If in case there is any IEDs that get triggered remotely around, they attempt to sort of force that remote triggering so that the IED explodes and other people don't exactly have time to come back and set another IED. And essentially, basically, they render the IEDs useless by exploding them before time. So that is what they, plan to do, the igniter vehicles, which look just like this, by the way. These are jammers. And in case some IED does not explode, that is when these jammers come into play and jam all radio communications in this area so that, the IEDs never can explode. So, yeah, that's what I wanted to tell you guys. Let me know if I got any of that wrong, and let's go ahead and read the mission debriefing. This is the sixth, rather. 40 kills, of course, I killed everybody. I had to, didn't I? The President of Indonesia would like to express to you his sincere appreciation for your efforts on behalf of himself and all the people of Indonesia. Of course, I mean, I let all your soldiers die so that I could take all the credit, of course. A warrant for the immediate arrest of the IMT leader has been issued directly from the President's office. Why had it not been President? Why had it not been presented yet, is the question. I mean, you knew that guy was inside of Indonesia. You knew that guy was an extremist militant. But it wasn't until there was an attempt on your life that you considered, hey, this guy is doing something illegal. Let us arrest him. He has asked that the team which protected his life do him the special honor of apprehending the terrorist commander and bringing him to justice. So basically, Bravo One has to, grab the IMT leader. I see. That, folks, is what you get. If you do a job well, then all you're gonna get is more work in return. And that unlocks the very final mission as well, which makes blackjack sort of optional. Locate and defuse the terrorist bomb, designated objective B, but it's not exactly optional. It's optional as far as the story is concerned, but I mean, if you are in fact a keeper of the peace, then this is something that is very important to you. It's sort of in line with, Delta Force objectives around the globe. So, the next time we come back, we will be tackling Blackjack, and this mission was difficult. This mission was difficult if you played it the way you're supposed to play it. I went ahead and did not do that, I just spammed my underbarrel grenade launcher, and yeah, it became easy in the flash of an eye. Like, all the cards are set against you in this mission, so essentially what you have to do is flip the entire table. So yeah, the next time we come back, we'll be addressing Blackjack. Thank you for tuning in today. Until then, take care. Farewell, fellow things.